Hey guys, this is David Kwan here. In this video, I'm going to talk about a pretty controversial topic about America and gun violence, really. It's not a response to the recent political discussion or the Newtown shooting. It's not really a response to that, although I'm pretty sure I'm thinking this topic is going to be not just this video, but it's going to have a lot more videos because it's a pretty big topic. But it's not a response to that. What made me think to do this video was recently I watched Bowling for Columbine, or rewatched it, because it's been a while since when I first watched it was years ago, and then I decided to rewatch it because I don't know, I was lying on my bed, and then I went to my Netflix app on my phone. I'm just like, oh, this is on here. Yeah, let's I'll watch this. So this video is actually more in response to Bowling for Columbine, or rather the question that I came to think about, because in that movie, or documentary, or whatever you call it, it's kind of a mockumentary in a way, in that movie, Michael Moore brings up this point that United States of America is number one in when you consider the developed world, I guess the developed countries being like European countries, France, United Kingdom, Great Britain, Australia, certainly, Japan, South Korea, whatever, the developed countries, maybe even China kind of fits along, even though they're kind of considered developing, kind of considered developed, I don't know. But when you have this developed world, United States is by far, in comparison, the country with the most gun violence. So Michael Moore tackles this issue of asking, well, why is that? Why is America number one in this issue of gun violence and gun crime rate and stuff of that nature? And in discussing that question, that's kind of like a lot of the movie focuses on this aspect, I think, although the movie also does go into a lot of different things. But that question really kind of struck home for me, because I remember after the Newtown, Connecticut incident, I was on the internet a lot, just reading a bunch of different stuff that was going on in response to this. And Michael Moore blogged again. He made a blog that pretty much makes the exact same points as Bowling for Columbine. So not much has, in that blog, he kind of argues that not much has changed. These are the same points I've been making, and it's kind of true even still, which is interesting. So the question, it's still a very interesting question. Why is America, the biggest country in comparison to the other countries in the developing world or developed world, why is gun crime rate or gun violence rate in America so high? Why is it the highest in the developed world? And so there's a lot of arguments that are made for that reasoning, and Michael Moore kind of goes over. Some would argue it's the violent history. America has had such a crazy violent history that's why it stems from this. And then Michael Moore kind of counters that by saying, well, look at Europe, look at Germany with this Nazi Germany, crazy violent history there. Russia, the Great Purge with Stalin, crazy violent history there. I mean, China was pretty much just wars and wars throughout its history. All these other countries have ridiculously crazy violent history. Yet their gun violent crime rate is really low. He dismisses that argument like that. And then there's this whole other argument about, well, it's the violent video game, it's the violent movies, it's the violent music that's making people do violent, crazy things. And it's generally accepted that America is the biggest export of that industry of movies and just entertainment, movies like Hollywood and games. So that's that argument, which, of course, he in the movie Bowling for Columbine, he has an interview with Marilyn Manson. Amazing interview. That's I think that's probably my favorite part about the video. Just Marilyn Manson and Michael Moore just talking to each other. He counters that argument really well, especially Marilyn Manson when he talks about just the media as a whole. This 24/7 news cycle where we're bombarded with stuff to be scared and terrified of, so that we'll buy products to alleviate that fear. And so all the commercials, the news cycle, Everything in the media is geared towards making you paranoid of something, to make you buy something to overcome that paranoia, which is an amazing point. So he counters that argument. And then there's the argument of like, well, it's because so many people in America own guns. In which, to counter that argument, he goes to Canada and shows that, well, Canadians actually, per percentage, own more guns than in America. It's like 40% of Canadian families own guns, just like a ridiculous percentage. So it's like, that can't be true. So what is it about America that makes it so special? And so that's kind of like, that question really made me think a lot. And so my the reason I'm doing this video is to just kind of wrapping my head around that question and just kind of responding to it. And I think Michael Moore in that video missed one really, or some important things here, a few important things. The fact that he is able to just dismiss the historical argument so easily is what kind of bothers me. I think history actually is probably the biggest component of why America is like this. So the argument shouldn't have been that, like, oh yeah, America is a violent country and that's why gun violence is so high. I don't think that's way too simplified here. One thing that makes America special in its history is that it was founded on guns. I mean, it was founded by a war, as most countries are, the Revolutionary War. But at the same time, it was a war that pretty much started with a bullet, or the bullet that rang around the world. I forget the phrase, but somebody shot a gun that started the whole war. And that started the birth of a country. How many countries can you say has began with that, with a gunshot? This is America. That's how it started. And, you know, not many other countries did that. Not only that, but the Revolutionary War started when towns and local towns and local governments and different states in the 13 colonies and the like, and even some, a lot of colonies, they started mandating that its citizens have guns in their homes. So that was a law. If you didn't own a gun, you were fined or imprisoned or something like that. So that's the beginning of this country. And that actually tells quite a lot. So I think to dismiss history on why America has such high gun ownership, but also this culture of like needing to own guns and having such a protective nature of the Second Amendment, of the right to bear arms, it's hard to see in any other country just fiercely protect that right. Like, this is my right to own a gun. And this is what I'll do to fight to keep that right. In many other countries, you don't see that sentiment. But in America, it's like the Second Amendment is one of the most sentiment-wise, I'm not saying legally, but like the sentiment that people have, I think it really does have that beginning in that history. And as we go further on in American history, it's more evident. That was the birth of the country. But also, as we go further on, it was also a method. Selling guns to the natives in return for different items, like their cultural products and such. That the way that the colonists did that just destroyed the Native American culture so totally, because Native American tribes became to rely on guns so much that they now had to produce different things to sell to the colonists to get those guns, and that ruined them. And the whole gun culture mentality enabled colonists to expand. And that's why 13 colonies that were mostly in the eastern part of the United States is now United States as a whole, stretching all the way to the Pacific Ocean, like to the coast over here. That happened because of the gun culture of America. So I think history has a big part. It explains so much why America owns its guns, and gun ownership is so high. It also explains kind of the demographics as we go further on into after Civil War is the Reconstructionist period, and that period is when it's one of the most racist period of the country. I don't know. That can be argued because, I mean, a lot of the periods in the country's history is pretty racist. But that was a time when, oh my gosh, slavery is abolished, but not really. Because there was a whole sharecropping thing going on that was virtual slavery, but also people who were like trying to follow this legal law now that slavery is abolished. So there are white teachers who are trying to teach freed blacks, you know, former black slaves how to read and stuff. Well, those teachers got bombed, got shot at, got hung, got lynched. Black people got lynched. White sympathizers of black people got lynched. It was a violent, crazy period, but it also explains why, even still, although this is kind of changing, even still, the biggest demographic for gun ownership is white males, especially in the South. And that the history kind of shows how that came to be. So I think we can't really dismiss history so easily, because it shows kind of like why America, the gun ownership is so high percentage-wise, especially among that demographic, although now it's changing. Gun companies are starting to realize that they need to expand their market, so they're now starting to market to females with painted guns painted in pink. They're now starting to market a lot to different ethnic groups. So the demographics is kind of changing with gun ownership. But for the most part, it is still majority of, like, I don't know, 55%, 60%, something like that. Not sure on the statistics. But yeah, so I think history explains a lot. But currently, I think the link to gun violence, now, the finding causality between gun ownership and gun violence is pretty hard. It's a lot harder than I think just a simple question of why is America so high in gun violence. But I think the causality there can be very linked to this media culture that we have, where, as Marilyn Manson mentioned, you know, we live in this 24/7 cycle of consumerism. So companies want you to buy their things, and then the best way they do that is to make these commercials or just kind of bring out a lot of these images. A lot of them are subliminal, a lot of them are just in the public subconscious, but it's there. It's that, hey, here's this thing, it's going to ruin your life, create some kind of fear, and here's a product that you need to buy in order to overcome that fear. So we created this culture or this media frenzy society where people are scared of everything. Watch the news. And this is one of my favorite moments in called Bowling for Columbine, when Michael Moore goes to a bar, in a Canadian bar, and he's like, hey, look at what these Canadians are watching. They're watching their news, and look what their news is broadcasting. And it's like a story about, I don't know, it's a pretty boring story, I think. I don't even remember, but it's not anything like the American News Channel. So that was like a pretty poignant moment, and I was like, that's really an interesting point to be made there, but it's kind of right. We do have, American society as a whole does have this culture. It's kind of a culture that drives on fear-mongering is public in order to, you know, expand this consumerism. A lot of big words here, but that's the gist I got from it. And I was just like, it kind of brings to light why America is number one on gun violence. And so that's kind of my kind of just thinking about this whole issue as a whole. So that's it for this video. In the next video, I kind of want to just talk about like the power of the roots, the historical and the cultural roots of, you know, and how it has impacted American society as a whole.